holds me together. Lately you say he been killing the vibe. Gotta be sick of this guy. Pull up skirt, get in the ride. Left hand is steering, the other is gripping your thigh. Light up a spliff and get high.
What up y'all, it's your girl Malaya and it's MT Nation. And in today's video we're going to be doing reacting to another scary story. This is called I Met a Guy Who Ate Human Flesh, or I Met a Guy Who Ate Humans. Yeah, guys. Guys, before we get into this video, make sure you comment, like, and subscribe. If you like this video, make sure you hit that bell so every time I post a new video, you guys be notified. And make sure you follow me on all my social medias. We'll be right here in link down below. But without any further ado, let's get on with the video. All right, y'all. So, I met a guy who ate humans. I'm so scared because this sounds so weird. Like, I met a guy who ate humans. What? But let's get right with it.
This happened when I was in college. I was 20 at the time, studying for an upcoming exam in biology. That is, until my roommate busted in my room. She wasn't yelling, but I could see she was drunk by her excitement. I rolled my eyes and sighed. I completely lost focus now. But it was okay. I'd kind of gotten used to her behavior. She was a party girl while I was, well, a nerd. I tried to get back on my reading tracks again, but she patted me on the back and drunkenly giggled before speaking. "Come on, Jasmine. Every time I see you, you're always reading a book." I sighed before speaking. "And every time I see you, you smell of alcohol and vomit." She frowned at me. "How about this? I'll be quiet all week if you come to this party tomorrow at 8. I wanted to say no, but then I thought about it. I mean, I do always work really hard. Besides, she won't barge in like this for the whole week? Sounds too good, I thought to myself. So I nodded and continued to read. We got ready. I hadn't dressed up in ages, so I was kind of excited. The party was loud, filled with drunk people making out, bumping, and dancing. The party was hosted in a basement-like setting, only it was much bigger and had a lot of space. I'm not going to lie, I did have a few drinks. I wasn't drunk, but I was definitely tipsy. So, as my view became tilted, this guy comes out of nowhere and has small talk with me. He was fairly attractive. He didn't seem drunk. We met and exchanged names. From what I remember, he had red dyed hair and blue eyes. He was white and about 6 feet. His name was Luke. We laughed and talked about topics like studying and books, and that kind of thing. The talking went on for about a half an hour. He then said, "Hey, I'm going to get another drink. Want anything?" And I said, "Why not? I mean, I'm having fun." So later on, he came back with drinks. And the next thing I remember, we were making out in the corner of the party room. It was so quick, and then he asked me, "Want to go back to my place?" Which I politely declined. I already know what he wants. Besides, I needed to be on campus in the morning. "Come on, I promise it will be fun." I remember that he kept on trying to get me to go, but he gave up after I made it clear I wasn't interested in going to his place. He rolled his eyes angrily and gave me a paper with a number on it. "Fine. If you change your mind, give me a call." He leaned close to me and whispered against my ear. Then he walked out, and the rest of the night was a complete blank. The next day, I woke up inside my college bedroom, on my bed, next to my roommate snoring on her bed as well. As I got up to shower, a paper fell out of my pocket. It was the number, which made me remember that guy. But I had more important things now. I showered then and went to study. I remember reading my book when all of a sudden I felt dizzy. Then I woke up in the bed with police officers and nurses talking next to me. Turns out I had this dangerous allergic reaction that could only be caused from saliva or any bodily fluids that had...
It's already going too far. Already. Sorry about the background noises, cars and stuff. Like, shut up.
Come from decaying or rotting flesh, which to my surprise was weird. I hadn't been kissing anyone, let alone ate anything raw. Then I remembered the guy. I told the police about the guy at the party and gave them the number he gave me. A few weeks passed and my allergies went down, so I could live my life normally. I just finished my test when my phone rang. I answered it, and it was the police. Turns out the guy from the party had two dead, decaying women's bodies inside his apartment that he...
Dude! The guy had two rotten, decaying girls' bodies in his house that he ate?
They must have been there for months. My heart dropped. The thought that I made out with someone who ate human flesh, or even worse, was what if I had agreed to come to his place? I may have been one of those bot.
Dude. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I see y'all in another video. Bye, MT Nation.